to the seventh round. Unfortunately, we don't have too much more action to bring you. The fight card has run a little behind schedule this evening, so we are running out of time rapidly. The conclusion to this fight will be up on the London Live website, the londonlive.co.uk, so make sure you catch up with that, London Live News as well, to check out the results. Jones just closing in, Parlagi on the ropes again, and this is promising to be a very interesting finish to this fight. Jones has put a lot of work rate into this, he's got himself into terrific shape. He looked a little bit drawn at the weigh-in yesterday, but nothing too serious. Marcus McDonald with just a slight warning for Jones.
If he did, Andy, you know, it was showing his fight, because this being fought at right frantic pace.
Right hand there from Parlagi.
I think Ben Jones has got to do what he's doing now, but more of it. Just take the player away from him, protect his vacuum. He's got great skills and great punch selection. But he just can't let him settle.
But he's staying on him, Jones, isn't he? There's a nice double jab from him over in the blue corner just a few seconds ago. And he's not leaving Parlagi alone.
If he's going to win this fight, he's got to win it ugly, unfortunately.
Jones looking
good
for the uppercut. Goes to the body with the right hand. Parlagi just swinging with the left. As you say, he does bounce on the balls of those feet. He hasn't really even got boxing boots on, has he? They're more like trainers.
They are trainers, and it's interesting. I think he's wasting a lot of energy what he's doing. He's got great skills, but there's nothing behind them punches to worry Jones now. That's the thing. His face is still a mess. The blood's just streaming down. The good thing about it is not in his eyesight. It's interesting what you said, Andy, about the weighing yesterday. I was wondering if, you know, that will have any effect. Because the only way he's going to win this fight is by pressurising Parlagi and making him fight his fight, which I don't think he's comfortable doing.
Well, Jones again just getting him backed up into the blue corner there, lets his hands go. The way he's up on his toes is almost like the remnants of an old amateur style, isn't it?
It is, and I think, you know, they'll check the vaccines in the old East Europeans years ago. That's what they were very good at. You can do it, Ben. Come on.
While Jones just making his way back to his corner again, they'll have to get to work on that cut. Always leaking blood more and more as the round progresses. But if you look at those corners, you look at Parlagi in the far side, there he is, sucking in that air, and here's where the cut was caused. There's that left hand that caught him on the way in. Different angle on the punch this time as he tries to jab his way in there. Jones, he just gets clipped, doesn't he, and down he goes.
I think the weight, the force of his foot going forward, and he just walks onto it. Wasn't such a heavy shot. It's when it's your force of you, your weight makes the punch.
And it almost seems to be a kind of vertical cut, almost just going down from the corner of the eye. That does actually look quite wide, quite deep, quite bad actually. But the doctor at no stage has really got too close and looked too hard and looked that bothered.
I think because the blood's running down the side of his face, it's not in his line of his vision, it's not causing no problems really. And in all fairness, the corner have done a great job, but again, it's seeping blood now as he's come back out.
Parlagi looking for the jab again, and then gets the right hand through. Now the left hand there comes out from Parlagi. Jones looking to go to the body, and again just the blood coming ceaselessly.
Parlagi having a good start this round, Andy. You know, he's picked the pace back up. I think his corner must have said to him, look, you know, last couple of rounds you let him get back into the contest.
Wait for him.
Jones just lets that right hand go as Parlagi just allowed himself to slip back onto the ropes. Left from Jones, almost found the hip, and then that was a nice couple of counter punches there from Parlagi on the back foot. Just timed them well as Jones was coming in.
He's throwing hooks around his main size onto that cut.
Good hand speed there from Jones. And Parlagi again just takes a step away to his left hand side. It's an all-action fight this, and Jones, you know, showing great resilience, great work rate.
It's very absorbing contest. Great skills from the man from Prague against the aggressiveness, the man from Crawley.
Interesting. He's come down in weight over the last few years. He won the Czech lightweight title. That was back in 2012, almost exactly 3 years ago. And Jones again just coming forward. Maybe the tank is starting to empty slightly for Jones as well. He's not been quite as busy in the second half of this round as he was in the first. Looking for that right hand after the double jab. It was a good shot, wasn't it, that caught him right at the start of the first round, because early stages, very early stages, as we said, just jabbing his way in, and then that left hand just came around and caught him.
Classy little shot, and you obviously wouldn't have seen it. He walked right onto it. He's done well getting himself back in the contest, but I just feel this round, he's let slip. The cleaner punching from Parlagi, he certainly won it for me. Just didn't really need Jones to really get back on the gas and really pressurise him. But with punches, you know, keeps marching forward, not really throwing an awful lot.
Parlagi launching the right hand from distance there as the bell goes at the end of the round. The Jones' supporters try and rally behind their man, Parlagi. Much as was the case for Joseph Lamptey, doesn't have any support in here whatsoever. And he's just getting toweled down in that opposite corner, and he looks happier in there between rounds now than he did in that previous minute. It's good defensive skills there for Parlagi, isn't it? Jones throwing punches, but none of them really landing, just sliding off him.
He's shown that throughout the contest. I think that last round was his best round. Now Jones' endeavour is really, really high, but I just think he needs to get a bit closer. That's a good right hand over the top. He needs to do more of that, because this fight is really, really close.
It's tight. I mean, how are you scoring this so far? It's difficult.
I think, if I'm honest, looking at my scorecard, it's got a round in it.
Well, it's the 10-8 to take into account, of course, the opening round, which would have been scored by Parlagi. You'd probably have given him the second as well, I'd have thought. But then yep. Jones, from that point onwards, has come back into the fight.
Three
points down, has come back into the fight.
And this is what he's better at doing. You know, to the body first, then the head. Busy, stay with him. Stay with him, be busy.
Well, he's called Duracell, as one of his supporters is pointing out over my right-hand shoulder here. He has got that energy, just trying to sustain that tempo if he can. It's been 10 rounds twice, Ben Jones, scheduled for it five times. Been 12 rounds once as well, so he does have the ability to go the distance, but we know that Parlagi does as well. He did it against Marco McCulloch. Jones has been sparring the likes of Yusuf Safa, good promising young fighter, down with the body shots in Crayford, Ryan Burnett as well. The same could be said of him. He sparred Cole Frampton before as well. Blood just raining down on us on ringside. Jones tried to get Parlagi where he wanted him, in the neutral corner just above us.
Better from Jones, good pressure from him. Good body shot there on the back foot. And Parlagi.
Jones trying to get to work to the body, but Parlagi just dropping those elbows, covering up.
I think Jones has got to stay in the pocket with him. Take the play away. Because he's definitely got the eye-catching shots for the judges. Parlagi, them single shots over the top. And Jones comes in.
Last minute of the eighth round. And Jones has got to fight 3 minutes of every round. Sinks the right into the midriff. And then looks for the right round the back of the elbow into the body. Both of these two just looking to get up those WBO rankings. The champion, of course, is Vasyl Lomachenko. He fights next Saturday night, actually, against Romulo Kasicha. Defended his title a couple of times after winning it.
Super champion him, isn't he, Andy? Like, got the most amazing skills.
I was looking at his record today, and it still just astonishes you that he's had five professional fights, 4-1 he is. Jose Maria Ramirez, I think, was 25-3 when he took him on his debut. Fought Orlando Salido for the WBO title in his second fight. Salido came in heavy, didn't really make any effort to lose the weight because he knew that he was going to step up after that fight anyway, and got the fight on a split decision, which actually really kind of angered me because it just wasn't a fair fight.
No, definitely not. And I think, you know, being the fighter, he obviously wanted to have an unbeaten record, but he's a super fighter, and he's in five fights, a world champion. Says it all.
Well, here's some action from that eighth round. Just two more to go. Jones has coped with that cut admirably. Lives in Dorking, splits his training between Ross Payne and Crawley, Lee Wilkins at the Body Shots in Crayford, and his old amateur coach George Brown as well, still involved. He's a full-time pro, but does run a business on the side. He's got something to sustain him other than boxing. Good energy here from Jones throughout that round. You've got to try and keep that up.
Yeah, I think that's the only way he's going to win this contest, by being the pressure fighter. Parlagi still looking nice and sharp.
Parlagi lets go with the right hand early in the round. Flipping left there again from Parlagi. Not too dissimilar from the one that put Jones down early on, but Jones just warmer, looser, better balance now.
It's better from Jones. I think that's where he's his success, up close. Good body shot from him.
Good solid sounding punch. We could hear that from across the ring here. I mentioned Salido, and Ben Jones was actually offered a fight with Salido not that long ago, but he had to go to Mexico City, and it was just for $10,000, I think, so just wasn't enough to travel that distance and fight that kind of man in his hometown.
I'm surprised that Ben, because he likes to fight anyone.
Well, even he didn't fancy that. Jones again goes to the body after he just jabs his way forward.
He's pressurised really well this round.
Left hand for Parlagi as he was on the move. Falls short with the right hand, and that could have been dangerous for him, but Jones was just too far away to make him pay for it. Still moving that upper body, Parlagi. Still relying mostly on those reflexes. He's throwing more punches this round. He's staying with Jones, isn't he, in terms of work rate?
He has. This last two rounds, he's done exactly that. And Jones is missing an awful lot. Throwing a high volume of punches, Jones. Got great endeavour. Done himself proud tonight as Ben Jones.
Yeah, Parlagi just leaning in there, looking to hold on slightly. Jones occupying centre ring for the most part. Parlagi just skirting around the perimeter. Back of his calves, his back never too far away from the ropes.
Be interesting, Andy, how the judges have got this, you know. What do you fancy? This is the skills of Parlagi or the work rate of Ben Jones?
It's the age-old debate, that, isn't it? People discuss that endlessly, and I talk to judges about it and ask if they're given any kind of directives as to what they're supposed to look for, and they're not. They just rely on their experience and what they prefer, but it does come down to that old phrase of, what do you like?
Yeah.
Do you like the man who brings it, or do you like the man with the better skills, the cleaner punching?
Yeah. It's a really interesting debate. I think everyone has it.
Well, bell goes at the end of the ninth. Just three more minutes to go in this one, and it could be all on this final round for all we know as the judges just fill in those slips of paper. Bob Williams away to our right-hand side, scoring this one. Other officials, Lee Cook and Victor Lachlan, the referee, Marcus McDonald. And I think it was after the sixth or seventh, I looked across at Parlagi's corner and he just looked to be blowing. He looked like he might be in a little bit of trouble, but he's found a second wind.
He has the last two rounds. You know, in fair play to Jones, you know, he's pressurised him. I think he had a better round the last round. But I think this could come down to this last round. He's that close.
Well, the applause led there by referee Marcus McDonald as he calls these two to the centre of the ring for this 10th and final round. This for the WBO Intercontinental featherweight title, and it's been a cracking scrap so far, it really has. Jones cut and down in the first round, blood streaming from that wound ever since then. He's had to carry the whole fight basically, but he hasn't let it put him off, he hasn't let it bother him. And he's come very much back into this fight. It's very, very tight. Parlagi still picking his punches well at times.
It's amazing, isn't it? You know, he's had blood streaming down his face every round, Ben Jones, but he's still marched forward, looking to grab this title. It's been a real excellent contest. Skill against Endeavour.
Doubling up on that doubt, jab Jones, and then letting go with the right hand. Parlagi again, just keeping those feet moving. The legs have never quit on him. Well, Jones just taking a little step back there. Parlagi was a bit open as he swung with the left and right hand, got caught by right hand from Jones.
Jones is having a good round here. Again, Parlagi's coming back. Good left up to the body from Jones.
Well, this is where it really counts. This is the hurt locker, isn't it? Into the last 90 seconds or so. Possible to know how the judges are seeing this one, but from where we've been sitting, it's a tight fight, it's a tight contest. But Jones is finishing strongly here, and that could be very important.
Jones has got ready to push home now.
What's it like when you're sat on that stool before a final round, knowing that you've got three more minutes, you've got to pour it out, you've got to pour out everything you've got?
I think a lot of it comes down to guts and bravery, Andy. I think, you know, and I think the crowd's helping now, Jones. I think you need that as well, that little push. But a chance to become WBO Intercontinental Champion must really drive you on. Jones is having a good flurry here.
Apology. Swung what was a pretty tired-looking left hook there a few seconds before that as well. His corner are just urging him on over on the far side as Jones just pushes him back into the ropes. Martin McDonald having a quick word about that. It's been a very clean fight, this, as well. The referee's not had to get involved at all.
It's been a great fight for that. It's, you know, there's been no dirtiness at all. Been very skillful.
Well, I've no doubt we'll have one of those scenarios when the bell goes where both fighters will raise their hands, both corners will celebrate, and we'll be in for that long, anxious wait to see who's won it as the scorecards are totaled up. And Jones again on the front foot, as he has been for the majority of the fight, just coming forward. And as predicted, they all celebrate. Everybody inside the ring celebrates. Referee Marcus McDonald applauds. Jones feels that he's done enough, as do his team around him, as do his supporters that he's brought here tonight. But the Parlagi contingent over on the far side, they think that they could have won this. Kuprian Hulia's trainer raises him aloft. They will be aware that they are the away team, as it were. Never easy to win on the road in the fight game. Wherever you are, whoever you are, wherever you've travelled to. No scorecards, no slips of papers being handed in, being added up. What's your gut feeling?
My gut feeling that it could be a draw.
Well, it's a possibility. It's a distinct possibility.
Such a tough fight to call. As we said, Andy, you know, looking at them here, that knockdown in the first round. You know, for Jones to get up from that, he was cut as well. He's done brilliant in the fight, you know. The corner work done, that was fantastic.
Well, it's a nasty, nasty cut. You can see the cut man just trying to pinch it together there. Pinch it together, apply some pressure, get that adrenaline solution in there. And see if you can just get it bound in any way at all. It never worsened. It seemed to be as bad at the start as it was at the end.
I think he done brilliant, Ben Jones. Maybe disastrous first 15, 20 seconds. Look, his eye's still bleeding now. He should be really proud of himself tonight.
Well, our MC still waiting for the supervisor to hand him the all-important slip of paper. Sometimes you can just get a little whisper around ringside. A reaction of somebody can just tell you something about which way it's gone. Nothing like that at the moment. Just trying to peer through the legs of the fighters to see if I can get any kind of a steer as to which way this may have gone. We'll have to wait for the MC, Mark Schmidt, who's just moving into position now. He's having a good look at that card, getting it straight in his head. And let's find out who's got it.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 10 rounds of thrilling action, we have a unanimous decision. Judge Williams scores the contest, 97 points to 93 points. Judge Laughlin stands, scores the contest, 96 points to 94 points. And Judge Cook scores the contest, 97 points to 93 points. All unanimous for the new WBO Intercontinental Featherweight Champion from Crawley, Ben Jones.
Well, Ben Jones gets it, 97 to 93 on two of the cards, 96 to 94 on Victor Lachlan's cards. The other judges being Bob Williams and Lee Cook, and he celebrates away to our right-hand side. He's hoisted into the air, celebrates with promoter Mickey Helly at the Parlagi corner. A pretty devastated, I think it's fair to say, handshakes all round between the two teams. They obviously felt that their man had done enough, but it was the aggression, the all-action style, the never-say-die attitude of Jones, really, that has won him that fight.
It certainly has, and it's interesting, as we said, we're sitting here, which is what you like. Scorecards are quite wide. It was such an absorbing fight, you know, to be literally 2 points down after the first round. It's an amazing performance from him, and the pressure of what he's done. He won it. The Parlagi corner have left the ring in disgust, you know, but it's Ben Jones's moment.
Well, that cut will take a bit of healing. There'll be stitches needed there, maybe some inside and outside. He's going to be out for a little while, that's for sure. 33 years old, he knows that he needs to get on with his career, to be honest. He's had a good career so far, but he knows, he feels that he's still got a lot left to offer, and getting up into those WBO rankings could take him closer to where he wants to be, to where he wants to go. Lee Wilkins just in the ring there as well, alongside Mickey Helliott. A real jubilation in that Jones corner, because as we've been saying, they got off to the worst possible start, and he had to show a lot of grit, a lot of bottle to get through with that kind of damage, with that kind of cut. And as you say, the corner did well with it too. It was an unusual one when you look at it, because as I said, it's vertical down from the side of the eye, but it did look pretty deep.
The corner done a great job, and considering every round he bled, you know, the fight himself done great. As you said, I think he needs a little time to heal that. But I hope now they can get him a real opportunity. You know, he's now going to get a top 10 ranking WBO. I think at his age, I think he's got to jump at, you know, hopefully he get picked as a voluntary defence, you know, and take that opportunity, because he deserves it.
Well, he looks to be going down that WBO route. The British champion is Ryan Walsh at featherweight. Lee Wood won a eliminator last week, so Walsh should be facing him next. The likes of Lee Selby at featherweight as well. Josh Warrington, of course, Warrington European champion, Selby IBF champion, defended recently against Fernando Montiel on terrestrial TV in America on PBC. Al Heyman's production, which seems to produce a card every other day. It's hard to keep up.
He's certainly putting some shows on, isn't he?
He really is. He's paying a lot of money as well. Fighters getting really good money, which is great to see.
Yeah, that's what's important. You know, it's nice to see that for the fighters. And it's nice to see our fighters, like a bit like Lee Selby, going over to America, and James Yagel going over there and putting on shows and winning. You know, years ago, that wasn't such a big thing, was it, winning in America? But now our boys are doing it.
Well, Ben Jones just stepping through the ropes. Making his way towards ringside alongside promoter Mickey Elliott. Receiving the applause of his supporters. He sells a lot of tickets. And somewhere down in that mix, I hope she's being protected, is Sophia. And she'll be talking to Ben Jones any moment now.
Ben, congratulations. You are now, let's see that belt, WBO Intercontinental title holder. But you were made to work for that. And looking by the cut on your cheek, you got in the first round.
Yeah, I knew it was going to be a hard fight. He's tough and he's sharp from the start. And all I didn't want was him to catch me early, like he's done. But lucky I wasn't hurt. I'm fit and fit as a fiddle. Got up and straight away got back to my game. Started thinking about boxing a lot more.
You certainly lived by your nickname, Duracell.
To be honest, I could have put more pressure on, but the thing is, the more pressure I put on, he started boxing clever. He was trying to swing for the big shots. So I had to be sort of sensible of what sort of pressure I had to put on. Just enough just to win the rounds, really. That was my game plan in the end, because he was just loading up with one, two shots.
Is it hard to stick to the game plan when you get cut like that so badly early on?
Definitely. Yeah, it is. It's one of the things you've really got to think about. And he's a tough lad. His record shows it. He's fought some tough lads and given tough people some tough things. I've watched a lot of videos. He's a tough lad. It was never going to be an easy game. And I come through. And this is exactly what I needed. I need that for experience as well. And he's a bit messy, but it's one of them type of fights, you know. So I really enjoyed it.
Mickey, you said it was going to be a little bit of a roll of the dice with his opponent, but he did get through it. What's next for him?
That was a real roll of the dice. It's a full credit to him. When he went down in the first round, I really had my heart in my mouth. He boxed very, very intelligently, and that win's just opened a load of doors for him. So we sit down with Kaz and the rest of his team on Monday. Who knows what next? But there's some big
names potentially. Ryan Walsh, British title. Lomachenko,
Lomachenko. Well, that's who everybody's dreaming. Lomachenko. You know, why not? Listen, it's possible. You know, we've got a good relationship with Lomachenko's people. We'll have a chat with them. See, if we could do that, perfect. But there's so many openings now. We sit down with his management and his guys, and Monday morning we'll go from there. We don't have to make a decision right now.
An exciting time ahead. You go and recover and enjoy that win. Congratulations.
Thank you very much. Yeah, I appreciate it. Thank you.
Hey, back to you, Andy.
But a humble man.
Ladies and gentlemen, straight on with the action. Please join me in welcoming in from Trowbridge, Dan Blackwell.